You're working a lot with shapely animations in Blender and you are annoyed that it's so difficult to adjust them, then I have a solution for you which makes it much easier to improve your animations and get the expressions you want. And the cool thing is, the addon is also able to transfer animations from mocap files and so on. So let's start.
First of all, we have to install it, of course. So we go into the preferences and then we click on install from disk and choose our addon. And now it's shown here and also in the end panel. Basically, the addon is divided into two parts. The first part is here in the end panel, and this is only for transferring the shape keys. And the main part is here in the object data properties under the shape key section, but more to it later. So let's transfer an animation first. And here we have an already animated face, and now we want to transfer to this character. And it's quite easy, you just have to select the source mesh and then the target mesh. Or if you want to transfer to several objects at once, then you can also switch here to collection and select a complete collection. This can make sense if you have something like here, so you have separate meshes for the main body, the eyes, the teeth, and so on, and they aren't sharing the same action data. Then it's much easier to do it with the collection, and then it will take all objects into account. And at last, you can also change the speed of the mocaps. So if your mocaps are recorded and made for 30 FPS, but you're working with 24 FPS, for example, in your movies, then you can easily change it here. In my case, the original mocap was made for 30 FPS, but I use 24 FPS in my films. So I have set it like this. And then I click on transfer shape keys. And here we go. So as you can see, all keyframes are transferred correctly. The only difference is that this animation is a bit faster because of the speed conversion, but this is totally what we wanted. But now let's come to the main functions of the addon, which is here under shape keys. And the first thing you will notice is this button here. And this is super useful because we have one big problem with shape keys. We can't hide shape keys in the timeline. So every time I want to adjust something, I can only adjust all at once. So like here, if I would move this keyframe, then I would move all keyframes here at once. And of course, this is super annoying and you don't want to adjust it always in the graph editor. The problem is if you're working with mocaps or complicated animations, then your graph editor will always look something like this. And yeah, this is super annoying, so you always have to deactivate all shape keys first and then only activate the ones you currently need. And especially if you have to adjust many shape keys at once, then this is really a nightmare. But now you just have to press on Show Only Selected and it will show only the selected shape key in the graph editor and in the timeline so that you can directly adjust it wherever you want. So like here, for example, if I move the keyframe and then choose another shape key where I can also adjust things however I want. And at the end, I can just press on Show Only Selected again, and then all shape keys are back. This also has another big advantage. Because if it's activated, then you can also see only the animation of the selected shape key so that you can better adjust it and see it without the intersection of the other shape keys. Then let's go a bit down, and here we can see the Shape Key Master tab. And here basically all the main functions of the addon that will allow you to improve your animations. So let's first take a closer look what problems we currently have here to explain the functions a bit better. And here we can see when she's blinking, then the eyes aren't closing completely. And then also the right eye is quite buggy here. And also the mouth with the stuttering. And also the general expressions and the speaking aren't very lively. And this is also a common problem, especially on cartoon characters. If you're working a lot with mocaps, then the expressions just don't look very lively. And then also here at the end, yeah, the laughing looks quite scary. So what can we do? At first, it makes sense to smooth the keyframes here so that we get rid of the stuttering and also that the general movement is a bit smoother. But before I press this button, here are all settings you can change for the smoothness function. And the general settings are quite good in most cases. The smoothing window defines how many surrounding frames are considered for each keyframe when smoothing the animation curve. And you can set this to low, normal, or high. And the outlier sensitivity stands for the direct strength of the correction. If this doesn't help enough, or you want to smooth it out even more for some cases, you could also activate the additional cleanup function, and then it would delete every second frame or the number you type here, and sets the interpolation for the curves to Bezier. But be careful with the setting, I would use it only if you want to smooth it out very strongly, otherwise I would deactivate it. And then you could also activate the recalculate keyframes function, then it bakes all keyframes new afterwards. For example, if you're using the cleanup function but still want to have one keyframe per frame, or you have keyframes in between the frames but only want one single keyframe per frame, then you can check this and then it bakes everything new. But we uncheck it for now and close it, and then we click on smooth keyframes. Then let's take a quick look, and as you can see, the stuttering of the mouth is completely gone, and also the stuttering of the eye, and the general movement is way better now, so it's not so jerky, it's way smoother. Then let's go to the next settings, and first of all with the offset and multiplier. And it's quite easy, the offset adds a constant value to all keyframes, shifting the entire animation curve up or down. So like here in this case, if I set the offset to 0.2 for example, and click on adjust keyframes, then it would adjust all keyframes with plus 0.2. But normally we don't want to change it for all keyframes at once, of course, so we can just click on undo here, and then it goes a step back. Besides undo and redo, we also have a reset button, and with that you can restore all keyframes to the original animation at any time. And the clear button is only important if you want to have a new base for the reset button. So for example, you've made some changes and you want to have this as the new base, then you can click on clear and then it will only go back to this level if you click on reset. So what can we do if we want to narrow down more the shape keys for which the adjustments should be made? Just take a look below and here are all options to narrow it down more, and these are valid for all settings. So regardless if you are changing the offset, the multiplier, if you smooth keyframes, or mirror them, it will always take these checkboxes here into account if they are activated. So first of all, I could limit the frame range, and here I can also set a specific blend in and blend out for a smooth transition. Beside that, I can also activate included shape keys, and here I can define all shape keys I currently want to change. And here's a big strength of the add-on, because you can define groups of shape keys you often have to adjust together, and this makes it much easier than searching them all the time together in the graph editor and adjust them separately. So for example, I could select eye blink left here and click on plus, and then maybe also eye blink right. And then if I click on adjust keyframes with the currently offset of 0.2, then it will only adjust these two shape keys. And then we could also define these shape keys as a preset. So I just click on save preset, and here I can type in a name. So for example, I can say eyes and click on OK. And then if I click on load preset, here is my preset. And here, just to show you, if I load it, then I have the shape keys here back. The add-on also comes with some predefined presets, so if you're using AirCAD shape keys, then you can also select some of these. So for example, if I select confused and click on OK, then it selects all shape keys you would normally need for it, and then I just click on adjust shape keys, and as you can see, it works. Or you could check excluded shape keys, and here it's the same principle but reversed. So all shape keys will be adjusted except these. And you can also save presets here. And then we also have a synchronize option here. And you need this only if you have several objects like here, but they aren't sharing the same action data. Then you could click on plus here and add all objects you want. And then all adjustments you will do here will also be done on the other objects. Then let's come to the multiplier, because with that we can adjust the general strength of the expressions. Because if we take a look, then we can see, yeah, it doesn't look very lively, and also the mouth movement here is way too little. And all we have to do is crank the multiplier a bit up and click on adjust keyframes. We haven't checked something here, so we made the change for all shape keys. And now let's take a look. And as you can see, the expression looks already way better now. And also the talking here is a bit better, but this is still not enough, I would say. So let's make another change only for the mouth. So here I would say we need jaw open. Then we click on plus and then on adjust keyframes again with the multiplier of 1.5. And yeah, it's good, but this part is still too little. Yeah. Then I would say we also check the frame range and we limit it at frame 80. And we stop maybe here 140 with a blend in and blend out of 10. And then I click on adjust keyframes again. Yeah, a bit more. And now we get there. Yeah, this looks already quite nice. Yeah. Perfect. And then we also have this strange part here left, and we could now adjust it manually with the offset, or we could also use the mirror function, because the other side looks quite good. So let's see which shape key it is. And it's probably this one. Yeah. So let's only add this shape key to the included list. And we also have to adjust the frame range here to maybe something like this, that we start here. All right. And then I click on mirror left. And here we go. And at last, we also had the problem that the expression was way too strong at the end. And we made it even stronger because we didn't limit the frame range when we multiplied all keyframes. So I would say we have to start here maybe with the correction 175. And then we can deactivate it because we want to have the change for all keyframes. And then I multiply it with 0.25 and adjust the keyframes. And here we go. And at the very last, we still have a little problem left here. So we could maybe mirror just the complete side with the correct one. In this case, I leave it unchecked so that we will change all shape keys. And I will set the blend out to 0 because we want to have it until the complete end. And then the start frame, I maybe set to 205. And then I mirror it. And here we go. And it's already better, but still a bit creepy. So let's see which shape keys are causing the problems. And yeah, probably these two. So let's add them to the list. And I activate included shape keys again. And set the multiplier back to 1 and the offset to maybe minus 0.2. And I click on adjust keyframes. Yeah, perfect. So I hope I could show you how powerful this tool is. At least for me, it was a game changer for editing mocaps and other things. And maybe it can help you too. So check it out and see you soon.